Atrial fibrillation is a common condition affecting over 350,000 Canadians. It is a problem with the electrical system of the heart. The signal for the heart to beat is based on electrical activity. The heart has four chambers, two on top called atria, and two on bottom called ventricles. The atria pull the blood and send it down to the ventricles, which are the main pumping chambers. Usually these chambers work in a coordinated way, with one signal from the top chamber causing one beat from the bottom chambers. In atrial fibrillation, the electrical activity in the atria is disorganized, causing them to shake or fibrillate. There are two main consequences of atrial fibrillation. Firstly, because of the disorganized electrical activity, the top chambers send many signals to the bottom chambers, causing the heart to beat quickly and irregularly. This causes palpitations, shortness of breath, or dizziness. This abnormal heartbeat can be controlled with medications. The second major consequence of atrial fibrillation is the risk of stroke. Because the top chambers are not contracting normally, the blood pools, which can cause a blood clot to form. If this clot is pumped to the brain, it causes a stroke. Usually, these strokes tend to be large, causing people to be unable to speak, move half their bodies, or look after themselves. How can we prevent a stroke? Because the cause of a stroke is a blood clot, the treatment is a blood thinner. Aspirin is a blood thinner and reduces the risk of stroke by about 20%. There are more powerful blood thinners like warfarin or coumadin that can lower this risk by about 60 to 70%. Warfarin is not an easy medication to take. Dosage changes over time, and regular blood tests are needed to ensure that the blood is thin enough, but not too thin. People taking warfarin will need to be careful of what they eat, because warfarin has interactions with a lot of foods and medications. Newer blood thinners don't require blood tests and are as effective as warfarin. While blood thinners prevent strokes, they put people at risk of bleeding. Your healthcare professional will talk to you about whether a blood thinner is right for you.